It's a scientific endeavor full of uncertainties. A total of 34 rare crested ibises will be released into the wild. In the following days, the birds will have to undergo numerous tests in the wild. Hardships keep coming, and one ibis dies after another. Can they survive such tests and eventually fly free? In August 2013, many provinces in South China are confronted with one of the worst droughts in more than 50 years. The temperature in Dongzhai National Nature Reserve, located in Henan Province, is just as high. Three crested ibises have died within just a couple of days. Wang Jiashi, a staff member of the Nature Reserve's Crested Ibis Breeding Center, is quite anxious. In just over a month's time, the Nature Reserve is going to release some crested ibises into the wild. The first time this has ever been attempted in the history of this species. The crested ibis, one of the world's most endangered species, is referred to as the panda of birds. Currently, there are a few more than 2,000 crested ibises living on this planet. This miraculous bird came into being approximately 60 million years ago, and it became a native inhabitant of East Asia. With its white feathers, bright red crest, and long black beak, the crested ibis is known as a gem of the Orient. In ancient China, it was regarded as an auspicious bird. In Japan, it was enshrined as a sacred bird by the Japanese imperial family. However, with the advancement of industrialization in recent centuries, the habitats of the crested ibis have shrunk dramatically, to the point of almost non-existing. Since the 1980s, crested ibises living in Russia, Japan, and the Korean Peninsula have successively gone extinct. At present, China is the world's sole habitat for wild ibises. Yang County in Shanxi Province, the original range of the crested ibis, is also the hometown of Wang Jiashi. Here, signs of the crested ibis can be seen almost everywhere. And it's also the place where, in May of 1981, Chinese experts found the last 7 wild crested ibises in the world. After decades of artificial reproduction and protection, the colony in Yang County has reached a population of 1,000, accounting for more than 60% of the world's crested ibises. Much of this is owed to the efforts of Wang Jiashi. In 2007, China decided to protect the crested ibis from extinction due to an oversized population, infectious diseases, and natural disasters by introducing an ex situ conservation program. A breeding center for crested ibises was set up in Xinjiang, Henan Province. For this reason, Wang Jiashi was invited to work with the center. His family decided to come with him.
Since
Since they moved to Xinjiang, his wife hasn't been able to find a job. She sells some assorted sundries close to their home. After many years of artificial breeding, the population of the crested ibis has now risen to more than 160 in the Dongzhai Nature Reserve. However, as a result of captive breeding, their survival ability in the wild is dangerously low. The best solution is to reintroduce them into the wild.
07年过来以后，我的人生目标就是祖环在野外放飞成功的。因为你不可能一辈子的一个笼子里老养一只祖环。如果这祖环不能在野外能适应这个野外的环境，你说养了这个再多没用。Dongzhai
National Nature Reserve, located at the northern foot of the Dabia Mountains separating Henan and Hubei provinces and on the southern bank of the Huai River, is an important base for bird protection and scientific research. It's also the place with the most active bird activities at the same latitude around the globe. It used to be an important natural range of the crested ibis. This was a crucial factor in choosing this place for releasing the birds back into the wild. It's very risky to release the crested ibis. At present, the rate of survival for released crested ibises rests around 40%. All the previous sites chosen for their release were in Shanxi province. If the crested ibis is to be released in Henan's Xinjiang, which is more than 1,000 kilometers from its original home, it's hard to say how many of them will survive. Some have wagered that none of them will survive at all. There's now little more than a month left before the release of the crested ibises. To provide them with water and reduce their mortality to a minimum, Wang Jishu, along with his colleagues, has selected a hilltop pond 2 kilometers away from the protection center. Having worked for 5 hours in high temperatures, a roughly 2,000 meter long water pipe successfully draws the water from the pond down to the big net cage. This is a net cage made of steel. It's more than 30 meters in height with an area of 2,900 square meters. The 34 crested ibises to be released are first housed here. The net cage contains simulated surroundings such as ponds and wetlands. It's mainly used to train the crested ibises in foraging and flight, as well as strengthening their defense against predators. Today, Wang Jishu has another important task. He will attach GPS trackers to the birds set to be released. The device not only records certain patterns, but also provides a means for the workers to give them first aid if they're in danger.
Oh,
哎呦，
那毛的头上毛的好像
没有虱子吧？
头上有出血的吧？看吧，
不
是抬了点，抬了点，刚才看不到头，现在抬了点点，让它缓一会儿。上次有只鸟碰了，缓过来了。
1 month later, a seminar on the release of the crested ibises is held in Zhengzhou. The participants include Chinese experts studying crested ibises and members of a crested ibis protection body from Japan. The ibis is a national treasure in Japan, which is why the Japanese team is participating in the release program.
他还是希望在以后的放飞中，咱们能采取自然放飞的软翅放飞的方法，让朱鹮呢，它能经过很长时，就是经过一段时间，让自己走出网笼。
我觉得这个朱鹮先生这个建议我还不太赞成，因为什么？从实际情况看，它那个地方就是，你即使把底下的打开之后，朱鹮直接走出来的可能性也不大。所以这次呢，先暂时还是按照原来的方案。
At dusk on October the 9th, Wang Jishu is putting food in the net cage. The only difference is that this will be the last time for him to provide food to the 34 crested ibises currently housed here. Tomorrow, all of them will be released into the wild. On October the 10th, 2013, there's an official ceremony for the release of the crested ibises. This is the first time to release these ibises far from their natural range of Shanxi province. And with a total of 34 crested ibises, this is also the largest number ever having been reintroduced to the wild. The cage is opened. Freedom awaits. But the crested ibises aren't cooperating.
This is like, you touched the wall, it's coming out. Oh my God.
Finally, the first crested ibis flies out. However, something unexpected happens. As soon as the crested ibises fly out of the net cage, predators such as goshawks and golden eagles approach.
This is the most important part.
考验走环的，
对呀，
时候到了。
There are far more challenges facing these rare birds. For these captive bred ibises, in addition to avoiding attacks from predators, their primary task is to find a fixed foraging site as soon as possible. The crested ibises are extremely demanding when it comes to their living environment. During the daytime, they search for food in pollution-free and chemical-free reservoirs, farmlands, brooks, and wetlands. At night, they rest on the branches of huge trees not far from their foraging sites. At present, the places where the crested ibises live are the places with the best eco-environment. All of these factors make it more difficult for them to find proper foraging sites. More than 10 days have passed since their release, yet there's been no information about the birds.
这回放飞好大的好多的困难，因为最起码有个 GPS 是这个比较先进的一些，能提供一些走环的一些线索和的，然后我们根据的线索再去找的，更加方便的还方便点。谁知道目前现在这个好多的信息也没有，也是接收不到，外面的也没有反馈的那个信息比较少。嗷
嗷，王杰说。Has to search their potential habitats one by one. Without any exact information, finding a crested ibis in these mountains is as difficult as looking for a needle in a haystack.
He flies up, the wings are red. 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 The
wings
are red. The wings are red. The wings are red. The wings are red.他在那边叫啊，我现在非常着急，确实很着急。我晚上有时候也是，我就感觉是昨晚会跑哪去，我这心里在老在想，老在想。晚上有时候十二点还没睡着的啊。
To find the released crested ibises, staff members of the protection center have to go to the fields personally to search for them.They also have to tell the villagers what a crested ibis looks like, so that if they sight one, they can quickly report it to the authorities.25-year-old Mami Koike is a staff member working for the Japanese Crested Ibis Protection Organization. She's teaching students how to distinguish a crested ibis from other birds.
Her 羽毛是什么颜色？脸是什么颜色？
红色。
红色。嘴巴呢？
红。
是真的是红色吗？
是。
是吗？看一下。
红。
这是什么？
中国。为什么中国的巨帆这么多？日本的巨帆这么少？
因为巨帆它羽毛很漂亮，是不是？你见过吗？很漂亮。所以很多日本人呢想要它的羽毛，所以抓它打它，对，然后把它的羽毛要了，所以呢巨帆会数量中越来越少。
中国有多少只巨帆？
1000多。就一定要保护巨帆，是不是？
是。
爱不爱 书桓。那我们给你们发点纪念品。
好。
是我设计了一些书桓的文具。
On December the 18th, 2013, in a village 20 kilometers away from the Crested Ibis Protection Station, one of the ibises is found.
他猎的
那鸟就好近了，那嘴尖尖上红的都看见了。到猪圈我还没有十米远，所以他觉得非常近了。你表述的我情况，你百分之百是书桓。
我是第一个发现这个。
发现书桓。你不要说话，不要激动。逮个小泥鳅，这是什么？逮个小泥鳅，身上羽毛比较光滑，还有它这个体格啊，从它的这个觅食的这个现象看，还是非常健康的。它的这个能逮到泥鳅就是不错了。
Hard work always pays off. With the staff members' continued search efforts.In addition to those crested ibises staying near the protection station, as many as 9 of the released ibises have been found. While Huang Jishu is immersed in delight with finding more and more of the birds, he gets a message. A crested ibis has been caught in Zhu Ma Dian, more than 100 kilometers away from Dong Jai.
情况不是太好，它肯定是鸟是这个飞得太远，体能太差了，好像是飞不动了。这是带的云南白药，白药如果受伤了，给它处理一下。还带了些活血止疼片。
那当时我们坚定很，没有想到是书桓。不多几天，往一发，他们都看到了。咱省里那个采蜜检测站的，群里边的，发现这个，他的这是书桓。是您那边
是
是
知道吧？
哎呦，
这现在
跑编号
了，吃饺子啊！不行，先看看，先跑太远了，哎呀！
他这个是收紧了，然后一口气就是。
我们先把他抓走吧，好吧？我们先检查一下啊。
可以，检查一下。
我们先检查一下。嗯。也饿的不好轻。
To provide a better environment for this crested ibis, the staff members bring it back to the protection center. Wang Jishu hopes that after a period of observation and treatment, this crested ibis will fully recover. Then, it will once again be released into the wild. Unfortunately, however, the next morning, Wang Jishu finds that the ibis has died.
当时亲眼看到朱桓死亡以后，我心里非常疼，心非常难受的了。就是当时那一幕，感觉是人生好像时间怎么过不去那一段时间。
After that, several other ibises die one after the other. Meanwhile, several are still missing.Winter, with its low temperatures and lack of sufficient food, is the most dangerous time for the crested ibis. Can these birds survive the coming winter? At this point, it's anyone's guess. It's February the 8th, 2014, the 9th day of the lunar year, and the Dabia Mountains are seeing the first snowfall of the new year.
就是2007年那年，这是最大的一场雪猫，到现在就是今年算最大了。
The farmlands are covered with snow, and any water is frozen. The newly released crested ibises are facing a harsh reality. The severe drought of last summer has resulted in a food shortage. The slushy water is fatal to the crested ibises, which feed on aquatic organisms such as fish and shrimp.
This is a very big challenge, because this snow is very big, because it needs to be frozen for a long time to thaw.所以这块的觅食非常困难，不好找。它这个如果它站在这个雪边呀，如果站在水的中间还可以；如果站在雪边，它又带点白的，这么黑的是，实在难找，因为它这个雪莲这个颜色非常相似的。
Up to now, only 14 of the 34 released crested ibises have been rediscovered, and this total includes two dead ones.There's no news about the remaining 20.
Hey, come on. I'm just looking at them. I'm looking at them. I'm looking at them.刚才打野了，把这点花掉也打野了。
王继学 decides to wait a bit longer to see whether or not it will fly back. 2 hours have passed, but they haven't seen any sign of its return. Wang is visiting the places where the crested ibises have been spotted. He hopes to find them and provide some food for them during a period of food shortage. Of all the crested ibises,Wang is worried most about numbers 19 and 34. This pair of crested ibises has just been found. After several months of wandering, they finally found a fixed foraging site near a loach farm. But with the freezing of the water surface, they too will have difficulty finding food.
昨天来了，昨天来过，今天没来，今天就好像就是结了冰了，他化不了，他吃不到什么东西，他就走了。
Wang decides to provide some food for them.
他没有食物，因为他这个鸟不稳定，在这吃食觅食，长时间观察时他找不东西吃的时候，或者是这个冻结冰了以后，这是投食的最佳时间。到这偷点算了，哎。
No more than 10 minutes after providing the food, crested ibis number 19 flies back.
正好，哦天哪！今天刚偷食，它就要来了。哦天哪！正好在我偷食我地方。看它吃，我看它能吃到哪去。肯定好长时间没吃到泥鳅，哎呀，要抓泥鳅。嗯，吃了，吃嘴的。这是今天能吃个大餐啊，美食。
The harsh winter has finally passed. The feathers of the crested ibises have changed to ibis released into the wild. Numbers 19 and 34 are the most likely to be successfully paired. Since entering the mating season, They've been enjoying each other's company the entire time. Compared to the flashy courtship displays of other birds, the crested ibis's courtship process seems simple and short. Generally, the male courtship ritual involves calling in flight, grooming, and showing their bills. The most special behavior is the male crested ibis's picking up a twig with its bill and walking before the female bird. If the female bird agrees to mate, she will also grab the twig with her bill. At the same time, both of them will sing in a low voice. However, at this moment, a rival appears. Number 17 joins in the action. With number 17 joining in, the situation becomes complicated. Driven by hormones, number 19 feels threatened and begins to take action. Number 17 doesn't intend to give up. It would like to have another try. However, its second attempt doesn't win the female crested ibis's heart either. No matter how hard it sings, the female doesn't pay any attention to it. Having lingered for a couple of days in vain, number 17 finally flies away in search of a new potential mate. This unexpected love triangle has somehow affected the relationship between number 19 and number 34. They haven't mated for a long time. One of the criteria for the successful reintroduction of the captive bred crested ibises is to see whether or not they're able to breed on their own. Even if there's only one pair of birds which succeeds in breeding, it can indicate that this is a suitable place for habitation. This is also one of Wang's dreams.
想不到夜中人啊。
In March 2014, a drawing contest with a crested ibis theme is held in a rural primary school in Xinyang City. Mami Koike is the organizer of the event.
然后下来呢，也可以在别的地方找一找，还有没有人穿黄色的衣服？这个人也穿了红黄色衣服，对，那这个也弄黄色，是这样子，好吧？对呀。然后黄色用完了，再画别的颜色，这样弄的话，这个地方不会弄得很脏，好吧？颜色弄得比较干净点。
The crested ibis rose to fame in Japan more than half a century ago due to the deterioration of the environment.
因为珠黄的历史在日本也很长，所以还是很多人关注珠黄，因为呢，这个现在在日本的珠黄全都是从缅甸过来的嘛，所以保护珠黄不能说只有在日本。今天你们画的都非常好，但是画的都有点少，珠黄画的有点少，张莹，画的很可爱。<笑>那这个叫。 王梦婷，你这个画的很好。然后你把这个画呢收起来，卷起来，然后回家给爸爸妈妈、爷爷奶奶说一声啊，今天画的什么什么鸟，给家里面讲一讲好不好？
好。Spring eventually arrives. For birds living in this region, spring is a season of abundance. And it's during this time that some unexpected good news arrives.
Oh,
This pair of crested ibises is number 17 and number 10. Since their release, they haven't been seen very often. But from current observations, it seems they have succeeded in mating. Thus, they've become the first pair to be successfully mated in the wild, outside their traditional range. This couple has built their nest here. Their nesting tree has been chosen with great care. It stands in a U-shaped valley, embraced on three sides by mountains. The hillside can protect the couple from cold winds, and the tall trees help protect them from predator attacks. No more than 100 meters away from their tree is a village, and the surrounding rice fields provide them with sufficient food. Yet, successful mating is only the first step towards successful breeding. Since this is the first time for them to be parents, they're inexperienced in incubation. Moreover, the environment in the wild is quite different from that of the breeding center. A multitude of factors can contribute to a failed incubation or even abandonment of the nest. Therefore, Wang and his colleagues still have a long way to go. It's now almost noon, and yet the male bird is still standing near the nest. Having sat in the nest for the entire night, the female bird is starving. If the male bird doesn't fly away to get food, the female bird may abandon the nest due to hunger. And if both of the parent birds leave the nest, their eggs will be exposed to the cold air. If that exposure is long enough, the embryos may die. Is the young father neglecting his duty, or is there another reason for his behavior? It's tomb sweeping day, the time for the villagers to go to the hilltops to sweep tombs and pay respect to their ancestors. And this means the villagers are frequently passing by the nesting tree. During the breeding period, the crested ibises are particularly sensitive to their environment. To protect their nest, they dare not leave it unguarded. Now, they're keeping a close watch on their surroundings.
You
那老百姓肯定不能理解啊！我一年就是祭清明节我祭这个祖宗，你还不叫人。
Something Wang fears most has occurred. It's a fire. The site of the fire is less than 200 meters from the nesting tree.
Good, good, good. 灭了！哎呀，终于打灭了！太危险了。到竹环草区了，因为这个火再不打，就马上进入草区了。
它如果要是翻过那个人以后，那火势不好控制。
你都没法控制，因为但是关键这个烟一熏，那个火一大，这个鸟马上就，我操，这鸟就起飞了，就起草了，说不定今天就失败了。哎呀，渴死我了！
At noon, the sound of firecrackers dies out, and the male bird finally feels relieved enough to search for food. Yet Huang's heart still flutters. He hopes this sort of accident won't happen again.
Change position, change direction, 走。你先过来吧，嗯，我现在就过来，是，以后看别的路可以走吧，别的路可以走，反正我们的鸟也马上快繁殖，到后面要抱，在树上头上那条路不要，最好不要走，往这边走，那我们好吧，我意思，我刚才给你开了一条路，理解啊，嗯，是这个树上，我怕现在是两只鸟子，慢点，嗯。
It's been raining on and off for a week, and this has provided sufficient water for the surrounding farmland. It's time for the farmers to transplant their rice. It's also a critical time for the incubation of the crested ibises. After more than half a month, the chicks inside the eggshells have taken their initial shape. At this stage, however, temperature plays a crucial role in the survival of the embryos. And in early spring in Xinjiang, the temperature varies a great deal. In addition to maintaining their own energy, the parent birds should keep their eggs at a toasty 37 degrees Celsius. So as not to overheat them, the brooding bird will stand up from time to time.
太短了，有两三秒钟，我还没看见它翻卵子呢，太短了。
你靠近了，你那个啊。想换了，看啊，这个雌鸟一看已经清明了，也不想走。
Today, mommy Koika also arrives at the village where the crested ibis pair is nesting.
有人吗？这是一个那个鸟，
见过这个鸟吗？
这个鸟是朱鹮，然后朱鹮在那边，
那个鸟不去烦，
对对对对，国家那个一直保护动物，国宝，中国的国宝。
前面有个窝，你知道吗？
知道。朱鹮现在住在这一块活动，所以呢，千万不要干扰它。哦，我第一次看朱鹮嘛，很高兴嘛，然后说啊，朱鹮，说了一句话，然后朱鹮嗖的飞走了，就在野外，我距离很远，所以我以为是它肯定听不到我的声音，但还是它听到了，然后它就飞走了，然后米田老师，
米田老师把你
干什么？生气，真的生气，我第一次被人家骂的那天是。
反正是应该是，
你不是
十五天是差不多，
对，十五天差不多。你比如这是最早应该十五号产卵，十五号产卵，今天应该
今天十五天吗？
今天有三十一号，
六天的，
今天三十一号，这个是六天，马上都破壳了。
On April the 17th, after being incubated for 28 days, the first chick pierces open its shell. Several days later, a tragedy occurs. A dead chick is found under the nesting tree.
The 鸟本来气质差一些，它没吃到多少，没挣到食物。然后这鸟不是挖草的时候，把它用它踩，又踩一下，只有这个可能。
One chick dies unexpectedly. What sort of fate is awaiting the surviving one? Wang Jishua is under mounting pressure. It's April the 28th, 2014, the second week of chick rearing. The chick is growing fast, and its weight has grown from around 50 grams at birth to over 400 grams. At the same time, it has a very good appetite, and its parents have to feed it 20 times a day. The parents won't be able to relax until the chick is about 40 days old. The crested ibis nest is about 100 meters away from the nearest village, and the village is surrounded by rice fields. Now is the time to transplant the rice. The worms in the fields are the ibis's favorite food. In order to gather more food, sometimes the birds have to search for it right under the villagers' noses. When the parent birds have eaten to their heart's content outside the nest, they will pick up some twigs or soft grass and bring it back to make the nest bigger and stronger. This time, the father bird has forgotten to bring back some twigs with him. The bird simply breaks a twig from a branch near the nest to please his mate. Otherwise, with the passage of time, the chick will grow up and the nest will become overcrowded. Compared with this couple, another crested ibis seems rather lazy. Instead of building its own nest, it's taken a fancy to a magpie's nest. In front of this unexpected invader, the magpies show no sign of weakness. After facing each other down for a few minutes, the magpies take the initiative in attacking the crested ibis. Though smaller in size than the crested ibis, magpies are at an advantage because they're determined to defend their home and they're greater in number. The crested ibis has no choice but to admit defeat and flee. The temperature is rising gradually and the birds living at the waterside are becoming more active. However, this is not a good omen for the crested ibises. With the rising temperature, the odor of their excrement pervades the air, and this in turn lures snakes, which have had little to eat all winter long. Because of the humid climate, both water birds and amphibious animals thrive here. It's an ideal foraging site for reptiles.
这下太多了，这个，这防护不算，这太危险了。
Snakes and eagles are the predators of crested ibises. Prior to this release, some crested ibises were let go in Shanxi, and some of their chicks were devoured by snakes. To guarantee the safety of this chick, one must take several precautionary measures. Wang won't let himself relax until he feels he's done everything possible to protect the birds. It's the weekend and the local fair brings an increase in business to their small store. Wang decides to go back home and lend his wife a hand. With the crested ibises constantly on his mind, Wang seems somewhat distracted. Now it's time for the female bird to take care of their chick. The male flies away from the nest. What Wang dreaded most has occurred. A cunning snake has avoided the tree trunk sprayed with arsenic sulfide and inches close to the nest from a branch of a tree nearby. With its feathers standing on end, the female bird cries wildly for the return of her partner. For a bird living in the wild for the first time, the mother has already been very brave. Finally, it fights the snake with a fierce peck. Yet this is far from enough to save the life of her offspring. The panic-stricken female bird flies around the nesting tree, shrieking desperately. Within less than 5 minutes, the male bird flies back, but neither bird dares to approach the snake. Finally, a villager removes the snake with a bamboo pole, but it's too late to avert the tragic end of the young bird. Upon learning of this, Wang rushes to the site.
我心好疼了，我心好疼，我都意想不到的事情，我想能再发生了。稍微工作上稍微放松的事情，主管就出事情。
There can still be a remedy to the situation, and that is to put another chick in the nest as soon as possible. While still in the chick rearing period, this pair of crested ibises is strongly attached to the nest and the chick, so if the dead chick is replaced by a living one within 24 hours, they may accept the new bird as theirs. Half an hour later, a half-month-old bird is delivered from the Crested Ibis Breeding Center. But this one is less than half the weight of the original. The size and weight difference is a critical factor in the acceptance process. Even if the couple want to adopt this new chick, there are two questions to be answered. Firstly, as a captive chick since birth, will it know how to ask for food from its adoptive parents? Secondly, will the adult birds take the initiative in feeding the chick? At this moment, nothing is for sure. The heart-stricken female bird is nowhere to be found, but fortunately the male bird is perching on the nesting tree. Will the male bird spot the differences between the two chicks? And will this artificially hatched chick accept its new home? The father crested ibis notices the chick in the nest. It hesitates a little. After all, this bird is much smaller than the one he has just lost. While the father bird is still hesitating, one movement of the chick changes the whole situation. It reaches out its bill into that of the male bird for food. This move is dramatic and touching. The male bird doesn't hesitate. It pacifies the chick while calling continually for the return of the female bird, as if saying that their child is still alive. The city of Xi'an is where the Japanese Crested Ibis Protection Organization is based. Mummy Koike is on her way to work. Having been living in China for 6 years, she's very familiar with the city. Currently, Mami Koike is drawing a set of cartoons related to the release of the crested ibises. Through her work, she hopes to help protect the crested ibis.
Her
work on the cartoons isn't going smoothly.
那天我突然有这个，就有感觉，然后就很随便的画，所以一点都没有觉得满意，觉得很太随便了，应该要再继续玩，画一画就好了。现在是一个想法，所以不是很，内容不是很好。For
inspiration, Mami Koike returns to Dongjai to closely observe the crested ibis. The crested ibis couple has completely accepted their adopted son. They seem to dote on it, barely leaving it alone.
你看我青鸟跑到一个杠子上来了，跑到斜杠上来了，跑到一个树枝上来了。小鸟结了，都变翅膀。
It's May, and the scorching midday sun has penetrated through the leaves. The crested ibises are breathing with their bills wide open. Fortunately, the nest is sheltered with leaves from nearby trees. This provides not only cover for the nest, but also shade. Most of the time, the mother bird protects the chick from the intense light.
从8月份，从八月开始嘛。
Today, Wang and his colleagues have something very important to do: attach a band to the chick's leg.
带上两个，这个容易。
The leg band will help them identify the bird in the future.
单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单手单
好像都是搞打了，皮打了呗。
你把绳子下去，把绳子放下来。
Despite being faced with a sudden intruder, the chick doesn't seem afraid at all. It's actually somewhat curious. Since everything is going smoothly these days, Wang would like to take this opportunity to observe the other released birds. After going through one hardship after another in the wild, 10 of the 34 crested ibises released have settled down in Dongjai. Although no signs of mating and reproduction have been found, they have gradually adapted to their life in the wild. Sometimes, they even fly back to the Crested Ibis breeding center. After a big meal, this crested ibis flies away completely satiated. At the end of May, the adopted ibis has grown up. In a period of just 1 month, its weight has risen to about 2 kilograms. It's now almost as large as its mother. It begins to fledge, and this means it will soon be able to fly. The chick's initial flight is an indicator of the success of the release. It's also important evidence for the crested ibis's successful adaptation to the wild. Juan is looking forward to this moment.
关键是其实再不能出现任何笔录的确保它侧背的发育快得很呢你今天一个样子你今天看着明天一看就是不一样了它这羽毛的长得多快呢。The
chick flaps its wings every now and then at the edge of the nest. However, each time it intends to fly away, it's frightened by the great unknown and stays put. About 2 days prior to its flight, the chick has had almost no food from its parents. The parent birds are using this to urge the chick to learn to fly. To push the chick to fly, the parents sit on branches near the nest in the hopes that the chick will fly off. The chick seems somewhat impatient. It pecks its feathers with force and looks irritated. The parents, being the pushovers they are, decide to feed the chick. To urge the chick to fly, the mother bird walks frequently between the nest and the branch. As the chick seems indifferent to its mother's guidance, the parents decide to leave him alone for a while. On May the 30th, having stumbled several times, the fledged chick finally plucks up its courage and makes its first ever flight. The first thing the fledgling chick does is have a good bath. This is its first bath. Being a fledgling chick, it has no experience in foraging. Therefore, over the following days, it will follow its parents wherever they go. While the parents are searching for food, it will play. Whenever it feels hungry, it will come to its parents for food. As the days pass, the parents will teach it to master various abilities, such as contacting other crested ibises and identifying predators. Mummy Koika has finished her drawings. In these cartoons, she's sketched out a dream. And it's not only her dream, but the dream of others as well. After this successful release, Wang returns to the Crested Ibis breeding center. A new batch of chicks are about to hatch. Perhaps in the near future, they'll also be released into the wild.